Here now with meteorologist Daniel Graves, and I absolutely love this shot behind you because we're starting to see the sun finally poke through at the end of the day.
A little bit late. But you'll get to see a little bit more of it as we go for the start of the week. But overall, no rainfall to worry about. If you have some evening plans, hopefully after a Saints win, you're just going to need a jacket because it's getting pretty cold. Let's take a look at temperatures across the U.S., and you can see we're finally starting to tap into that colder air to our north as winds have shifted to the north. So you see 30 right at Kansas City, 34 up toward Minneapolis, and so some of that cold air is going to be visiting us tonight. Right now, we're in the mid 40s to the low 50s. You see from 24 hours ago, we're a good 15 to 20 degrees colder. And what's going to be happening in our forecast is, of course, we're going to start to warm back up. So it is going to be chilly for the next several days. You can see through Tuesday morning, we'll have lows in the 30s and 40s. As we go toward the end of the week, yeah, our highs are back to right around the upper 60s to the lower 70s. However, another change looks to be happening. A lot of this cold air from Canada may actually finally be plunging toward the south and showing some much colder temperatures arriving by the end of next weekend and into the next week. You can see it shows New Orleans showing a temperature of 29 degrees next Monday morning. Our coldest temperature so far has been 36. That'll be something to watch as we go throughout the week next week. Meanwhile, right now, satellite and radar is quiet for us. We do have the cloud cover still hanging around. There's the clearing line, so we have the clear weather just to our west. So I do expect these clouds to gradually start to thin out overnight, and that's what will allow our temperatures to continue to drop. But overall, you see not much happening across the U.S., and as you look off toward the west, no big storm systems for us. So looking ahead over the next several days, we're looking at some dry weather, partly cloudy to mostly sunny. Tomorrow, we keep the sunshine and cool temperatures through Tuesday with highs in the mid to the upper 50s. By Wednesday, clouds start to return, highs into the mid 60s, and this is out ahead of our next cold front that's going to be arriving as we go toward Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. You see some scattered showers starting to move in throughout the day on Thursday. Friday, we may get a little bit of a break. And then here comes that cold front on Saturday, and that's going to bring the potential for some heavier rain as we go through the day. And going into Sunday, see a little bit of wintry weather just off to the north in parts of Mississippi. Not expecting that for our area here, of course, but something to watch as some colder temperatures will be moving in by next weekend. We've had some breezy winds today out of the north, 5 to 10 miles per hour on average, but you can see a little bit higher at Gulfport, 18 miles per hour, 16 over at the lakefront. So it does make it feel a little bit cooler out there, but I do expect as we go through the overnight hours, those winds will relax some. 5 to 10 miles per hour as we get into Monday morning, and they'll keep that speed as we go throughout much of the day. So tonight, decreasing clouds, will be cold though, in many areas on the North Shore and into coastal Mississippi, touching the mid 30s, but overall low to mid 40s with that light wind out of the north at 5 miles per hour. Tomorrow, mid to upper 50s, so a mixture of sun and clouds. We'll still be chilly as we go through the first half of the week. As we check out your 7-day forecast, we continue to see those temperatures starting to warm back up. We'll have some chilly mornings and comfortable afternoons. Rain chances return for Thursday, parts of Friday and Saturday, and then Sunday is where we'll start to watch that much colder air moving in, because highs right now looking like they won't even get out of the upper 40s.